Thursday.
Retail workers sold rice against people 14 days.
I'm with UFPW Local 648. I'm an ex-union worker. I used to work at Safeway for 13 years. And even though it was a union job, every week, the schedules were not, we weren't getting set schedules. And that's what we're fighting for. Part-time workers getting regular schedules. So, yeah, people, you know, this is not just me. I mean, I'm saying this for not only for me, but for everyone, especially that works in the retail industry. You know, you work at Ross, you work at Apple, you work at all these jobs that only recruit people that work part-time. That's not enough. We're fighting for minimum wage. We're fighting for part-time workers to get equal rights and entitlements. And I just want to say that we're all in this together. We want to fight and bring justice to this. You know, we live paycheck to paycheck, and there's so many retail jobs out there, and there's so many of us. So we're not going to stand for that. We're for minimum wage, and we're for part-time workers, and we're in it to win. So let's fight.
Oh, yeah. Fenced up sidewalk over there. So let's head over to Powell.
Follow the fucker.
Follow the skull puppet in front of us over there.
Follow the puppet, guys. Two by two, we're going to march on.
Increase the standards for retail workers in San Francisco. So at the face of this struggle are the workers. So I want to invite our allies from the Chinese Graphic Association, worker Bing Rong Tan, up to the mic, please. Let's give it up for them.
Hi everyone, welcome all of you here to fight for the minimum wage with us. So this election, we're hoping that we'll be able to raise the minimum wage so that it'll help low-income families like my own, you know, to improve our living conditions. I currently work a part-time job, and I really would like more work hours so I can have more income to support my family and improve our living. And I know that this dream is not my own dream. I know all of you out here in many different communities share the same dream.
Alright, folks, try this one. Down with the red, up with our pay. Let's go red, have a say. Down with our red, up with our pay. Let's go red, on front pay. Down with our red, up with our pay. Let's go red, on front pay.
Fight only. We have our brothers and sisters in the East Bay, in Oakland, that are also fighting for an increase in the minimum wage. So, in solidarity, I want to invite up Bezale Naiga, who's here with the East Bay Organizing Committee, and is a fast food worker at Burger King. People, and they're always cutting our hours because they want to cut corners and save money.
He tenido que ir a trabajar aún estando enferma, ya que yo no puedo faltar a mi trabajo, aunque esté enferma, porque si lo hago, me castigaría cortándome horas o hasta me podrían despedir. Además, si falto mi trabajo,
escucha.
Estamos en la lucha.
Walmart speaking. All across this country, Walmart workers are fighting, and they're fighting for the same thing that we're fighting for here right now. They're fighting for $15 and full time. All right, Dominic?
Yeah, Dominic.
How's everybody doing today? Yeah. Are we excited for 15?
Yeah.
Are we excited for 15? $15 isn't enough. $15 isn't enough, but it's a good looking start from where we're at right now. I can't even tell you guys that we are with you guys. We're marching, we're fighting the streets everywhere in this country. We're demanding a living wage, and it's so powerful. This is the golden state, you guys. I'm so proud to be from the Bay Area, but just let you guys know, being a single parent father, working for Walmart, I was not able to support myself and stay an honest man doing an honest day's work, you guys. A guy that changed his life, just like another a lot of brothers and sisters that's from the Bay Area. I'm talking to them right now because they're not here. I'm representing them as well. It's getting turned to the streets, you guys. It's getting turned to things that they do not need to be doing, and they're really good people. So us getting a better living wage, getting people off the streets, and getting more people in the schools and doing positive stuff. So this is not just for people with families. This is for people without families. This is people on the street. This is for our homeless brothers and sisters. This is big. So I just wanted to come feel my love and march, and this is cheap fight. I don't want to hold you guys up too much, so I'm going to leave with that. Peace that
fighter!
Peace that fighter! Let's win! Woo!
All right, thanks, Dominic. Also, we know we couldn't do a lot of the fights without our good friends and allies at City Hall. And one of the meters that helped us get the consensus measure for the highest minimum wage in the country, I want to invite our ally and our good friend, Supervisor Jane Kim.
Woo!
Good evening! We know that San Francisco is leading in the country in income disparity and the widest gap between our lowest income workers and our highest paid workers. But we also know that here in San Francisco that we have always led the movement to make positive changes for our workers throughout the country. And this hasn't come from City Hall. This has always come from the national worker movement throughout the country, but also the incredibly strong movement here in San Francisco. It allowed us to pass the first universal health care program in the country. It allowed us to pass the first paid sick-day ordinance in the country. It's now being replicated in other cities and throughout the state of California. We also, 10 years ago, led the country and passed the highest minimum wage 10 years ago here in San Francisco. And we're going to do it again this November. We all know that voters support passing a high minimum wage. Everyone feels how expensive this city has become. But we will not win if we do not get out the vote. We know that people support raising the minimum wage and the fight to 15, but we got to make sure that we're knocking on doors, we're phone banking, so that people know that this is on the ballot and to know to come out and vote on November 4th. So fight for 15!
All right. I also want to bring up now another good ally at City Hall, Supervisor David Campos.
Thank you. Muchas gracias. Que viva los trabajadores.
Que viva
los trabajadores.
Que viva.
So I want to thank all of our workers for being here, and I want to thank our retail workers. You know, we in San Francisco have always led the way in terms of how we treat workers. And we are going to send a very clear message on November 4th when we pass the strongest minimum wage in the country with Prop J. But you know, we have to do more than just increase minimum wage. We have to make sure that we support the basic rights of our retail workers, which is why we have to pass the Retail Workers Bill of Rights.
Yes.
We need to make sure that our workers have a schedule that actually allows them to put food on the table. And it's really sad because right now people are struggling. Our retail workers are struggling. They need a work schedule that will allow them to actually make enough money to make a decent living here in San Francisco. And I also want to talk about our security guards in the tech worker industry. Our security tech workers are helping to make the tech industry financially successful, and it's only fair that they get a just contract. They need a fair contract so that they can too benefit from the tremendous prosperity that we see in San Francisco. We are at a crossroads in terms of the history of San Francisco. We are the wealthiest country, wealthiest city in the country, and yet we have the fastest growing inequality, and we want our workers to be able to afford to live in San Francisco. So we have every right to expect that we as workers are going to get a decent living wage here in San Francisco. Quisiera agradecer a los trabajadores que han venido hoy. Queremos que San Francisco continúe siendo un líder en el tratamiento de nuestros trabajadores, no solamente incrementando a $15 la hora el mínimo aquí en San Francisco, pero también que apoyemos los derechos de nuestros trabajadores que trabajan en el área de retail, porque necesitan trabajar suficientemente horas para poder comprar comida para sus familias. Queremos que nuestros trabajadores puedan vivir en San Francisco, puedan ganar lo suficiente para poder vivir en San Francisco. So I want to thank you. We are 27 days away from the election, and on November 4th, we're going to send
as outreach material that we're going to go out and talk to workers around here in this plaza. Okay, so after we close up the rally, please walk on over to Michelle. She's going to give you materials to be able to do outreach. So la manera que vamos a alcanzar a lograr que pase esa propuesta es hablando con los trabajadores. Entonces, después de que cerremos aquí, si pueden pasar a donde está Michelle en el árbol, les va a dar materiales para hacer alcance y hablar con todos los trabajadores aquí, porque tenemos que asegurar que sepan de estas propuestas. So, ¿están conmigo? ¿Are you with me?
Power.
We got the power.
What kind of power?
People power.